Let's continue our discussion of Flexi Layout Studio's Flexi Layout Language. Sometimes we abbreviate that to FLL, Flexi Layout Language. Let's talk about pre-search relations. We're going to touch on a variety of topics, including use cases, search controls, restricting search areas, using the nearest method, and so on. The first thing to notice is where you write code for advanced pre-search relations. So on the Advanced tab, it's in underneath the external fields above Advanced post-search relations in the Advanced pre-search relations. This code is executed immediately before searching for the image object that corresponds to the FlexiLayout element. First, FlexiLayout Studio will use the properties you specified on the tabs to the left of the Advanced tab, and then it will run the code. This is an important point. If a particular parameter is specified both on a tab to the left of the Advanced tab as well as in the code, the code will have priority. So keep that in mind. And then logically, if a parameter is specified on a tab to the left of the Advanced tab but is not specified in the code, of course, the value of the parameter from that tab will be used. So essentially, with pre-search relations code, we can execute a search for whatever we're looking for. Essentially, it's the logic of the search, how we go about finding the data for these fields. We can introduce conditional arguments as well as restrictions on how we do the search. So with pre-search relations, we can control the search. For instance, if a certain element is not found, then don't find the element that you're writing code in. So you can do effectively a stop search. Also, using pre-search relations code, we can create complex search areas. And we can take a quick look at how that's done. So here I've got a layout, and you can see the search area here, in fact, is complicated. There's a rectangle here, a rectangle starting right here and ending there, and a third rectangle here. We know that search areas are highlighted in gray, and we can tell that by right-clicking on our image and seeing Show Search Area. So the date isn't being found here. That's another topic I'll touch on in a second, but the complicated search area is woven together with FlexiLayout language. So if I open up this element and I click on the Advanced tab, I can see that I've got advanced pre-search relations code here. And essentially what's happening is there's a rectangle that's being defined to the right of the keyword using FlexiLayout language. There's a rectangle being defined below the keyword, and a rectangle that's being defined to the far right of the keyword. And I happen to have used a rectangle array to create this combination of search areas. So here's my rectangle array code, where I'm adding the second and third, and I'm restricting the search area then to my rectangle array AR. So while I'm here, I'll just point out that whenever you're writing code, you want to always click the check code to see if there's any errors. I'll go ahead and close this out. And I also mentioned that there are items that are being excluded from the search area. So we can see the search area. Let's go back in here. And let's click on search constraints. And we can see that we've got some repeating group elements, and we're excluding all instances of those elements. So I've got an exclude date repeating group, and we can see it right here. We remember the repeating group icon, and that repeating group is essentially finding all dates on the form. And we're saying when we're looking for an invoice number, we don't want to find a part of an invoice date. We don't want to find a complete or partial date at all. So it's a very simple thing to create a repeating group that will find all dates and then simply use that as an exclusion here. And we're also excluding currency values. And also under different conditions, we can reset the parameters using conditional arguments for items that you could set with the GUI, but the problem with setting the GUI is that you can't execute those GUI arguments based on conditions unless you use FlexiLayout language. And search control. Here, for instance, you can use the function don'tFind. So here's a simple example. If the invoice header is not find, then don't find this element. And I just said that, you know, we really need FlexiLayout language to execute these conditional arguments, but this one's an exception. So let's take a look at that. So we can take a look at a FlexiLayout. And here we see we've got a static text element finding the keyword recipe %colon, and then a character string element looking to the right of that and finding the recipe number. The code that we could add here is do not find element if the reference element keyword recipe number, the static text keyword, is not found. So that prevents us from having to write the code that I just showed you. And this is a really important feature here, because especially with repeating groups, I find that it can be really problematic when a static text element isn't found. Then the character string element, I liken it to a horse that likes to jump the fence and roam freely. So it's going to look anywhere for this character string element if this keyword wasn't found. It's going to start at the upper left-hand corner. It'll start at the upper left-hand corner and find the first string that it matches. So this is really, really an important feature. You can write code if you prefer, but in this case, you can use the GUI. And here's another function, stop if found. And for instance, you could use this for a repeating group. And the logic would be that once you find some thing that you would consider a table footer, you could execute stop if found, and that would make the repeating group function stop searching. We also have the ability to change an element programmatically from required to optional, or vice versa. And we can also change the maximum number of hypotheses that can be found. Now, there's a GUI setting for that as well, but that's fine. Here, we could introduce a conditional argument and only change that under certain conditions.